Joint replacement surgery has become a common procedure which involves removing a severely damaged joint and replacing it with an artificial implant. Dr. John Quigley of Methodist Hospital in Arcadia explains the dramatic results of this procedure.
To speak about a knee replacement, you're replacing the cartilage. And to step back a moment, the cartilage is that smooth covering of the bone. For instance, if you look at a chicken bone, the end of the bone has that smooth covering, then that's cartilage. When that wears down, then you have the bone rubbing on the bone. And when you lose that cartilage, that's what we call arthritis. Now, arthritis refers to inflammation of the joint. It's a generalized term. But the most common cause is that loss of that cartilage. So that cartilage covers the bone, and in the knee joint, it's not only the end of your femur, which is your thigh bone, or your tibia, which is the leg bone, it also includes the kneecap, the patella. The signs that come from arthritis of the knee will start with being variable. They'll come and go is the most common finding. And there'll be some vague pain frequently. Now, having said that, sometimes it will be related to a previous injury. Sometimes it's swelling that they note. But in general, it'll be a vague pain that starts and slowly increases in severity. To help slow it down, one can help do activities and treatments that help decrease the inflammation in the knee. Exercises, I think, help, particularly non-impact loading exercises, such as cycling, walking, or swimming. Running or jogging where you have impact is to be avoided if you have significant arthritis. Injections, again, to decrease the inflammation. For instance, steroid injections can help do that. Synvisc, there's hyaluronic acid. It's a substance similar to what you have in your knee. That can be injected. As far as getting to the point of a knee replacement, first we'll evaluate the patient. We find they have arthritis. And this can be done on usually it's an x-ray finding that you can diagnose the arthritis, but frequently it's the patient's complaints as well. As far as the time for the total joint replacement, it's when the patient has reached the point that the pain and disability is such that they no longer wish to put up with it. After they've tried conservative care, which may include canes or crutches, anti-inflammatory medication, braces, and rest.
Dr. Quigley discusses how the surgery is performed.
The operation itself involves coming in, having the surgery. It usually takes about an hour to an hour and a half from the time you're put to sleep until the time the last suture is placed. Prior to that, frequently you'll have the anesthesia, which can also include a nerve block, which will numb the nerve so that you don't have pain afterward. Usually you're in the hospital. It can vary for even 1 to 3 or 4 days. Frequently patients will need some further rehabilitation and can be transferred to a rehab unit in the hospital. After the surgery, the patients start usually with a walker. And then depending on the surgery, we'll be up walking without a walker in 2 to 3 weeks and then continue to progress from there. Sometimes patients ask about driving. If it's the right knee, usually we'll hold off for 4 weeks. If it's the left knee, hold off for 2 weeks because you're using the right knee to drive. But the bottom line is when the patient gets to the point they no longer want to put up with the pain and disability. Frequently, patients will hear that there's a 15-year study or a 20-year study. And with that, the patients will understand that this knee will last 15 to 20 years. Those studies that are 15 to 20 years, usually 90% of the patients are still have a good functioning knee, 90 to 95%. So in general, the answer would be to 90, 95%, it'll last probably your lifetime.